What area are you from?
Sherry.
Were you a member at the time the old church was here?
Yes.
What do you remember about the old church?
That it was full. People attended afternoon and evening services.
Well, I'm Johnny Myatt. I'm from Sumter, South Carolina. Graduated from South Carolina State University in 1967. Came to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Went to Park Place, Amy Church a few times. And while I was looking for an apartment, I came down here on Webster Avenue and saw this big, beautiful church. I didn't know what denomination it was until I looked at the sign. I found out it was an AME church. And I was AME when I was in South Carolina. I said, well, I'm going to go to this church this Sunday.
I am Mary Burley. I joined Bethel AME Church at the age of 15. Was very active in the church as a young person. We were residents of Sheridan at that time, which they thought was very far out, which now isn't, because a lot of people live there now.
My name is Linda Thompson, maiden name Daniels. Been a member of Bethel Church from birth. I'll be 70 in January of 2020. So most of my, all my life I've been here. I started off at the old Bethel, which used to be where the Civic Arena used to be. I remember a lot of every day, every Sunday, walking down to the church with my brothers to Sunday school and with my mother. My father was with us, but he attended a different church sometimes. So it was just my mother and my brothers. And we enjoyed it. We remember collecting pennies to build this church. They had all the little kids bring in pennies and made us feel like we were helping the church. So we would run around and look for pennies and bring them and, you know, happy that we were bringing pennies to help build the church.
My name is Julius Lee Red. I'm from Phoenix City, Alabama. I started attending Bethel AME Church in 1967, and I became a member of Bethel AME Church in 1968 under the late Reverend Reuben Everhart. I was appointed to the steward board under the late Reverend Reuben Everhart. He also recommended that I be hired as a mathematics teacher for the OIC, the Opportunity Industrialization Center.
Can you tell me what you remember about what the church looked like?
Well, it was a large church, a very large church. In fact, it was larger than this one. And we had 300 or 400 members coming, not just on roll. And our clubs were very active. Each club had a Sunday where they would perform.
We lived up on Bedford Avenue, up right at the street here. We would walk all the way down to Wally. And it was a beautiful church from what I could remember. Everything, of course, when you're little, everything looks bigger. So the doors looked gigantic to me. Everything looked, you know, a lot bigger. So, but I was young. I was like maybe, the times that I remember walking with my brothers, I was maybe like 5 or 6 years old, walking down there with them. And having fun on the way, getting in trouble, tearing my dress kind of things. Mother mad at me when we get to church because I, you know, climbing a wall or something because I was a tomboy. Yeah, so but we get down there and we do our Sunday school and stay in church with my mom and come back home. I remember those days. It was fun.
So
nightingales.
Can you tell us about the nightingales?
Young people's choir, mostly teenagers, because they had a choir that were younger people were in, that were 7, 8, 9, 10 years old. And we sang once a month Jenny Woods was our director, and she played for us. Charles Brevard helped sometimes with the young people's choir.
I participated in the Sunday school, the young people's choir, which is known as the Nightingales. Jenny Woods was our director. She was very stern. She had to do was look at us. She didn't have to speak, but just look. We knew we were doing something wrong. We would correct it right away. I was a member as a teenager, the ACE League, and that was really a good time then, because ACE League was on a Sunday afternoon at 6 p.m. And of course, the teenagers were there, the young men and the young women. And we fellowship together, and that's what we love most.
Cousin Roy was in the at the Army Academy, and he wanted to come here with some friends to meet some of the girls here. And there was several young ladies here around their age who went to Bethel, who was still at Bethel, who went to school around here. And I introduced him to several of these young ladies. And one of the young ladies was going to Pitt. Right now, she is his wife.
Reverend Macklemore asked me to chair the scholarship committee. It first started out, I believe, under Reverend Macklemore, along with the other ministers of the Hill District, that they call it 5-in-1. It was Bethel AME Church, Central Baptist Church, Calvary Baptist Church, Monumental Baptist Church. So that's why they call it 5-in-1. I may have omitted one church. I can't think of the name at this time. But those were the five churches, and each church would recommend or suggest a person they believe that were eligible for the scholarship. And one of Bethel's first students to receive the 5-in-1 scholarship was Nikki, Reverend Macklemore's daughter. And the scholarship ministry continued to grow. We've given out many scholarships, almost over $20,000 scholarships have been given out to Bethel members. And even just recently, we gave out $1,400 to one of Bethel students currently enrolled at IUP, Indiana University of Pennsylvania.